Hello students, now we come to the tropic movements. Well, there are different type of tropic movements our plants show. We generally read about 5 tropic movements that are included in your ICSE 10th biology book. So these are phototropism, geotropism, hydrotropism, thigmotropism and chemotropism. We will learn about them one by one. I've made some diagrams to make you understand what is happening in all of these. So first of all, the phototropism, photo as it is related with the light. So what happens when the sunlight or the source of light is above the plant part? So what happens, the shoot, it generally grows upwards. When the source of light turns to any direction, the shoot, it shows bending towards the source of light. So the shoot is moving towards the light. So we can say that shoots, they are positively phototropic. Positively phototropic means they are moving, they are bending towards the source of light. And the roots, what about the roots? Roots are generally negatively phototropic. They never ever grow towards that area where light is coming from. They generally move away from the source of light. So they'll grow always inside the soil, into the direction where there is no light is present. So if we talk about phototropism, so shoots, they show positive phototropic movements, and the roots, they show negative phototropic movements. In this, we can take an example of sunflower also. You generally saw a bending movements of sunflower. It is said that the sunflower, it used to turn according to the sun. What happens in sunflower is, well, we have read in the part of hormones that auxins are concentrated in the tip region of the shoot. When the sun is just on the top of the plant, the auxins, they are distributed equally throughout this region. But when the sun turns to any of the direction, what happens? The concentration of the auxins, it is more towards the side which is away from the sunlight. It is more towards the shader region. And we know the function of auxin is the cell elongation. It will help in the growth of the plant. What happens then? Auxins, when they start concentrating here, so the part, the cells that are present here, they start getting elongated. So these elongated cells, they simply, what they does, they bend this shoot. This side, the growth of the cells is less, and the shader region, the region which is opposite to the source of light, the concentration of auxins are more. That is why this region starts growing, and that is why it just bends. It looks like the sunflower has bent towards the sun. So this is about phototropism. Second is our geotropism. Geo, it is related with the gravity. It is related with the earth. So we knew it, that a tree, that a plant, it shows what, which part of the plant shows positive geotropism? Yes, it is the root part. Root generally grows towards the gravity. So the roots, they are positively geotropic, and shoot, which grows against the force of gravity, they are negatively geotropic. We can take an example. This is a potted plant in which potted pot in which we have a plant inserted. What happens? This pot fills by some beam, someone kicked it and it just fills. After a few days, what we have noticed, that the shoot region, after it is growing, see, horizontally, after a few days, it starts growing upwards against the force of gravity. It shows negative geotropism, and the roots that are growing generally straight, it just doesn't keep on growing this way. They bend towards the gravity. So they show positive geotropism. It's about geotropism. Now the hydrotropism. For hydro, it is related with the water. Hydro term is related with the water. What happens in hydrotropism? It is the growth movement of the plant in response to water or moisture. For this, we have taken an experiment. We have done this experiment. What we have done, we tied a wire net to a hook. On that wire net, we have applied a 1 or 2 inch layer, thick layer of moist sawdust. Then we put some bean seeds on it to germinate. So the bean seeds, they start germinating. Plumule, it grows towards the, it grows upwards against the gravity, it grows, and the radical part, it starts growing downside to towards the gravity, because roots are positively geotropic. Now what happens, this is the moist sawdust, they are hanging in the air. After a few days, what it happens, what the radical feels, that the source of water is nowhere around in the atmosphere. They are not finding any source of water. So the radical, they starts turning upwards again to this sawdust, which is having moisture. So the roots, which are generally positively geotropic, they show movements towards the source of water. So roots, they are positively hydrotropic. Roots, they are always in search of water. It is water which is attracting the roots downwards into the soil, because roots are positively hydrotropic, and shoots, they do not show any effect with the water presence or not presence, because they starts growing, they keep on growing upwards only. So this is about hydrotropism. Roots, they are positively hydrotropic, and shoots, they are negatively hydrotropic. Fourth one is the thigmotropism. Well, thigmo, it is related with the touch, the response to the stimulus of touch. Well, we can see a number of plants with soft stems, like pea plants, like cascuta veins, like cucumber veins. What they have? They have a soft stem, and they have a tendril, which is a coiled part of the stem. It may be from stem, and it may be from the leaf. So what happened? So the stimulus is perceived by the tip of the tendril. Then this stimulus is transmitted to the basal part of the tendril. So that's way. So this way, the whole tendril, it's get that stimulus. The whole tendril becomes sensitive to the stimulus. Once they receive the stimulus, the tendril, it starts twining around the support. Once it's twin around the support, so it will get a help to just stand up. Otherwise, this weak stem wouldn't keep it straight. So the movement of these tendrils towards this touch stimulus, this comes under thigmotropism. Now the last one is the chemotropism. Well, chemo means it is related with some kind of chemicals. What happens here? Chemotropism, we can see in the plants when after pollination, fertilization process has to take place. Once the pollen grain, it falls over the surface of stigma, it makes a pollen tube. Now why this pollen tube is formed, why it is traveling, and in which direction it has to go, who will tell this all? This pollen tube, it grows in response towards the sugar and peptones that are secreted by these neck canal cells. So the pollen tube, in response to these sugars and peptones, they just keep on growing and reach up to the ovule where axil is present. So this is all about the chemotropism by pollen tube. With this, all the tropic movements, they are covered. I hope that it is easy for you to understand. Thank you so much.